You're tuned into the BSX Digital Sports Network. You're listening to the boss of the big boy, JP the Techass. Vegas scoreboard express. Giving you that grease.
Good morning, Las Vegas, all my sports bettors around the world. It's time again to get into some money. Vegas Scoreboard Express, live here on KSHB 107.1 FM AM 1400. I brought them back this morning because they helped us make some cash yesterday. My main man, Ronnie B. from the Rand Park Casino here in Las Vegas. Good morning, Ronnie B. How you doing?
Good morning, JB. Doing good. It's a great Sunday morning.
That's what I'm talking about. And all the way back again from the Jersey Shore, John Ryan, rotowire.com. Predictive sports betting playbook giving you the grease this morning. College football, we did pretty good yesterday, guys. We gave out Alabama. Good morning to you, John. How you doing?
I'm doing good, JD. How are you?
Doing good. Yesterday, gave out that big dog, my dog of the day. Put the cash in your pocket. BYU over Baylor, 34-28. We'll talk about it. Another good one last night. Alabama going up against Georgia. Alabama, again, the dog that's rarely a dog. You got to take him and put cash in your pocket. Money line if you wasn't scared. We'll get into it when we get back from this short commercial break. And, of course, week four in the NFL. We got the picks that are on deck for you today to get locked in. Want to give a shout-out to my main man, Daryl Harris, CBS 8 KLAS here in Las Vegas. We're doing the fantasy football. Looks like he's up against me this week, and I am ahead, but I'm sure his team is going to make a comeback today, and it's going to be exciting. So you guys keep it locked here with me, JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Follow me on Instagram at JB the Ticket. Go to my website, jbtheticket.com. And most importantly, folks, it's football. It's time to get the money.
You're listening to the boss of the big ball, JP the Techie.
The London Bridge Resort in Lake Havasu is the perfect place to vacation in style. Their beautifully designed suites include stunning views, a kitchenette, and free Wi-Fi. The well-reviewed and affordable resort has tons of amenities, including a breakfast buffet, kids camp, a 9-hole golf course, 3 pools, a marina, boat tours, a water slide, and a great nightlife scene. London Bridge Resort is centrally located in Lake Havasu City, Arizona. Go to londonbridgeresort.com to plan your getaway today. London Bridge Resort, your Arizona Oasis destination.
This football season, stay in the game with Fubo TV. Over 100 live channels, including NFL Network, NBA TV, and FS1. Don't miss any of the action. Get 7 days free on us at VegasScoreboardExpress.com. Don't get cabled. Get Fubo TV.
All money, all sports, no bull. Back at you live. JB the Ticket and Vegas Scoreboard Express, people. Time to get some money. The NFL is on deck. We're going to go over some college football with you, and I brought him back with me, John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook, rotowire.com, and Ronnie B. here in Las Vegas, the king of the Rand Park Casino. So again, guys, we had a quick recap in college football. Want to talk about another game that we gave out yesterday, Michigan and Minnesota. We talked about it, Ronnie B. I'll throw this one up on you because that was the grease that got hot. You thought Michigan would get the win. You said go ahead and take these guys money line. But Minnesota, they were able to play some very, very good football as well. That dog was barking, got inside of their spread. But where Michigan is right now at 4-1, do you think they are legitimate college football playoff contenders, barring that first week loss from Texas? Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you what, Michigan has shown me that they're improving week by week. They got them ranked 12th in the nation. I don't know if that's correct or not, but they're playing some good, consistent balls on both sides of the ball. And I think they can make it to the top 12. Yeah, we'll see what happens, but I think they can get in the top 12.
There you go. Let's talk about one of the top 10 teams that went down yesterday. This was a dog that was barking, putting cash in your pocket. We talked about it. Kentucky, Ole Miss. We thought Ole Miss would run away with this one, but Kentucky was a dog with teeth, got out of the pound, and bit all up on those Ole Miss Rebels, 20-17, taking down that +550 money line dog. Going over to you, John Ryan. Ole Miss, are they for real? And when you look at where Kentucky is, hard-fought Georgia game, didn't get the win, but they got the cover. And then this game, top six team, taking them down on the road. Kentucky, are they for real? And is Ole Miss going to start to fade as usual? Go ahead, John Ryan.
I actually think Ole Miss is going to have trouble making the top 12 for the playoffs, because if you look at their schedule, it's not easy. They're on the road at South Carolina, then at LSU, then Oklahoma at home. Arkansas played really tough football yesterday. Then Georgia at home. Florida away, they probably win. Mississippi State, they probably win at home to end the season. But they could end up with four losses now that they didn't take care of business at home against Kentucky.
There you go. You talk about this SEC, very tough football all around. South Carolina's good. LSU is good. Georgia, Alabama. Let's get into it before we jump into this NFL. What a game it was. Alabama came out early, dominating, and then the next thing you know, wow, Georgia, on that dog comeback, man. These guys were in the dog position. You know you like in-game betting. John Ryan, I'll stick with you here. I saw the in-game betting got at least, as I think, one time up as far as 5.5, 7.5. If you were a Georgia fan and they were down early, did you get involved in with the Georgia game in-game betting? Go ahead, John Ryan.
Well, I actually did do a little couple piece of money bets on Georgia when they were +18. And it was 33-10 at that point. They
right.
were down 27 points, which this represented the biggest comeback in SEC history of a team, whether they won the game or not. They were down 27, and they came all the way back. And it is a top-five matchup. So it's the largest comeback of a top-five matchup in college football history, where the team actually had the lead. But
there you
what
go.
An incredible game.
There you go. You talk about Alabama going over to Ohio State, the number three team. They were able to obliterate Michigan State at 4-0. Haven't heard much about Ohio State this year. They're grinding. They're moving. Do you think they move into maybe one of the top spots under Texas? Go ahead, Ronnie B., and then get your thoughts on that. John Ryan.
I tell you what, Ohio State is the real deal. They're playing good football. They're going to continue to get good. And I think they're getting overlooked by a couple teams right now. So, the 38-7 yesterday was a showing, because they were at Michigan State on the road, and they came out smoking. And ranked number three right now, I think, is a good spot for them. But if they stay in that spot, they'll be in the playoffs, and who knows what happens in the playoffs.
Yes!
That's what I'm talking about, John Ryan. Your thoughts on Ohio State?
There's always the real deal, and I guess the reason they're so quietly doing this under the radar is this is what we expect them to do every single season. But it is going to come down to week seven when they go on the road to the West Coast to play Oregon. And these teams have not had to travel like this ever. So it is a new experience for them to have to do this during the regular season. But then the big showdown is week 10, November 2nd, at Penn State. And that is going to determine whether Penn State or Ohio State can go undefeated for the season, in my opinion. But then it doesn't get easier for Ohio State. They have Indiana, who's off to one of their best starts ever at, 5-0 now?
Long dog. I took them a cash ticket to win the Big Ten. Go ahead.
It's like 50 years that they've ever gone 5-0. So they're the real deal, too. And then, of course, they have the big rivalry with Michigan at home. They should beat Michigan fairly easily, I think. But that Week 10 matchup in November 2nd, I think, is going to really determine the Big Ten champion.
There you go. Let's talk about a couple of these fringe dogs here. Again, college football yesterday, I told you the dogs were barking. Money lines got opened up. Want to talk a little bit about Colorado. The Buffaloes went out to Central Florida yesterday and put a beat down on the Central Florida Golden Knights. Shout out to my guys over at Denver Sports Betting, Gilly and Ryan. But when we get into this type of situation here, when you look at Colorado, that defense, I was very impressed with what I saw. And Ryan and the guys over at Denver Sports Betting will tell you, when I went on their show about 2 weeks ago, that was one of my big concerns. But I'm not concerned about Colorado anymore. I think they can compete in the Big 12. I think they may even get to a bowl game. That is the goal for Coach Prime, and he's got the top two players in this NFL draft if they come out, and Travis Hunter and his own son Shedeur Sanders. So that win yesterday, again, Colorado getting down to Central Florida and picking up that win. I'm pulling up the score for you right now, but while I'm doing that, I'll go over to you, Ronnie B. Do you think Colorado is a team that not only can maybe get to a bowl game, but they can stay on your betting list here? I know I had taken them off early in the year, but a couple of folks told me that, you know, Colorado might be valuable. Again, that win total, 48-21 yesterday. Colorado was now 4-1, in a better position than they were last year. Do you think they'll even get into the top 25? Go ahead.
I'll tell you what, they're a hard team to judge. They come out hot sometimes, they come out flat other times. Yesterday, it was a very impressive win. I watched a little bit of the game, and 48-21, Sanders played a really good game, 3 touchdowns, had a passer rating over 170, only missed 7 passes. I mean, it was on target yesterday, and they played well on both sides of the ball. So, again, it's one of those teams I can't get a handle on to wager, but I think they can get to the playoffs if they keep moving in a positive direction.
There you go. John Ryan, your thoughts on Colorado. Do you think that they can not only move into the top 25 this week, but continue their prowess? And if they don't necessarily get into the playoffs this year, they're bowl bound. Looks that way to me. Go ahead.
I think they'll end up being a bowl team. I think they'll end up with an 8-4 record. Coming up is Kansas State. They're playing them at home, which is a good thing. But Kansas State really walloped Oklahoma State yesterday, and that is a ranked team. Then they have Utah down the road, Oklahoma State, final game of the regular season. So I can see 4 wins and 3 losses down the stretch here, which put them at 8-4. But they are building towards making the 12-team playoff maybe next season.
There you go. Last 2 teams here. Want to give a shout-out to the Running Rebels here in Las Vegas. No need for the quarterback that left. We got a guy named Hodge Malik Williams. He was showing off what he could do yesterday. UNLV all over Fresno State, 59-14. Got out to an early lead in the first quarter and never looked back. Hodge Malik, 182 yards, 3 touchdowns, and got one on the ground as well. I think he's the definite starter going forward. And UNLV at 4-0, they're on the coaches' poll. Do you think they can creep over to the AP this week? I think that would be a valuable situation for them. I think they deserve it. They handled the adversity well with the NIL issue. I'm going to leave it here dead. I suggest all the other journalists around town leave it dead as well. UNLV is a dog that is barking. And not only do I think they are bowl ready, I think they could be one of these non-Power 5 conference schools that if they continue to play well and dominate the way that they have been, again, that domination. College football playoffs, second year head coach Barry Odom. Ronnie B., I'll go here with you in Las Vegas. I know you're always over at the Rampart talking to the guys. UNLV, in my opinion, real deal, real dog with teeth, can put cash in your pocket. Do you think this is going to continue? Go ahead.
Oh, I believe it is. And yesterday, a lot of people put some money in their pocket on UNLV. That was an impressive win yesterday. I was watching some of that game as well, and I think they're the real deal. It's the speed is there, the defense is there. The quarterback didn't seem like it missed a step, so I think UNLV can have a good season.
There you go. Their next big test, the big test of the conference coming up next week, Boise State. I'll throw this one over to you, John Ryan. We saw what Boise State did yesterday to my late-night dog, Washington State. Obliterated these guys all over them. The Cougars couldn't get it done. The Broncos kicked them right in the teeth. You talk about UNLV going forward, though. Maybe a one-loss season for them. That would be a fantastic season. And if they are a one-loss team, if they're not able to get past Boise, which I think they're going to put up a good fight in the dog position, but the rest of that schedule looks really, really soft, and I think that they can get to the college football playoffs if they play their cards right and continue to dominate the teams that they are playing. Again, no slip-ups. Boise is the game they're looking for. But if I was Boise State right now, I'd be afraid of a running Rebels team dropping 50 points a game. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think I agree 100% with what Ronnie and you are saying here. And Malik Williams is a veteran. And it's kind of mind-blowing now that the previous quarterback left because of a $100,000 payment that was verbally communicated. There was no contract, et cetera, et cetera. We talked about that on yesterday's show.
Bye-bye.
But in my opinion, when you read this guy's bio, and granted, he's coming from the preschool of Campbell, but he set all kinds of records in that division. and in that conference. So he brings a lot of high-end experience with him. And they're not playing the Alabamas and the Georgias and the Penn States and the Ohio States of the world. They're playing teams that are good, but they're capable of beating them. So I like his leadership, especially yesterday. Really, like, bye-bye to that quarterback. See you later. Don't let the door kick you in the you-know-what. But we don't need you, and we got Malik Williams now. And I think that was a monumental game for the program yesterday.
That's what I'm talking about. UNLV running Rebels, getting the job done, 4-0. My vote's for you guys. AP Top 25. You got one already. Let's go ahead and round it out with the USC Trojans. We are the home station of the Trojans here yesterday. Wisconsin scared us, but they came back, covered the spread, put the beat down on them, got the over, got the money line, 38-21. USC at 3-1. Do you think that they're going to be able to move up into the top 10? Ronnie B., 10 seconds. John Ryan, we'll go to the break with you. 10 seconds. Go ahead.
Well, USC broke my heart yesterday because I had Wisconsin. So I don't know. They didn't look too good in the first half, but they came on strong in the second. So it's very possible if they keep improving.
There you go. You talk about USC in-game betting, dog position. Are they one of those teams you want to keep on your betting book? John Ryan, go ahead, and we'll take this break.
Well, that was one, too, I was looking at. I didn't pull the trigger on it because I just didn't trust USC. I guess recency bias from the ups and downs of previous seasons. I didn't pull the trigger, but that was a pretty impressive comeback. At the same time, guys, Wisconsin is not the Wisconsin team of years past. It is definitely a weaker edition of them. So let's not get too much involved with this great comeback. But nevertheless, USC got a very important win.
There you go. USC got the win right here. KSHB 107.1 FM AM 1400. Guys, you stay on the line with me when I get back. More money, more grease. JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Let's get it.
You're listening to the Boss of the Big Four, JP the Ticket.
Get ready to showcase your brand to the exploding sports betting and fantasy sports audience to elevate your business this season. Advertise on the VSX Digital Sports Network, broadcasting locally on KSHB and nationwide on iHeartRadio. Experience the power of digital and broadcast radio with great value, fast results, and no hassle. Reach a dedicated audience and watch your brand soar this season. Discover why VSX flagship show, Vegas Scoreboard Express Live, is rated number one on Good Pod, 5 stars on Apple Podcasts, and top 5 on FeedSpot for best radio podcasts in Las Vegas. Get your brand in front of an engaged and loyal audience who are looking for the best sports advice and great offers. Advertise with VSX Digital Sports Network. Your success is our commitment. Visit VSXDigitalSportsNetwork.com or call 702-909-0585. Take your business to new heights this season. Don't miss out on this opportunity to connect your brand with sports enthusiasts across the nation with VSX Digital Sports Network. All money, all sports, no bull. Visit VSXDigitalSportsNetwork.com or call 702-909-0585. Log on or call today.
You're tuned into the VSX Digital Sports Network.
I hate
fire, more heat. You're listening to the Boss of the Big Bull. Giving you that grief.
Vegas Scoreboard Express.
Always spitting that explosive fire.
Back at you live, JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. You know what time it is. Time to get that money and put cash in your pocket. NFL Week 4, it's here, guys, and we got to make you money because today we got some dogs that are barking. Again, my main man, John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook on the line with us. And Ronnie B. here from the Las Vegas Casino called the Rampart over in Summerlin. So, again, guys, we've been talking about it the last couple of weeks. Dogs have been barking in the NFL. They've been cashing. John, on the free play that you gave out last week in the NFL, the Philadelphia Eagles were able to get it done on the road in a tight nail biter for the New Orleans Saints. But I want to talk about a team today that is actually in a worse position than the team that they're playing, who we thought were going to be in a bad position, in a worse position, but they ended up leaving Vegas with a huge win. Let's get into it. Rotation number 271, the Cincinnati Bengals, -4.5, -220. The line makers here are Still not high on the Carolina Panthers, but after what I saw last week, we may have to put a little bit of pizza money on it, as John would say. Rotation number 272. The Panthers, a resurgent win last week here in Las Vegas in the dog position. The Red Rifle was able to get it done. If you listened to the show last week, Mark Hayes was on giving his thoughts about Carolina, but they were able to pull out a dominant win. They're plus 4.5 today, plus 185 in the dog position. Bengals are 0-3, though. I'll start off with you, John Ryan. My question is the right bet today the Carolina Panthers in the dog position at home? You know I like home dogs. I think they're going to do a lot better with Andy Dalton. When you saw what he was able to do here on the road, I think coming back home and letting Andy Dalton maybe get his career comeback going in Carolina. Apparently he's been on the roster for about 3 years, so he knows the offense. He can step in. He's got the experience. Do you think this is a turnaround for the Panthers? And also, Bengals, do you think they go to 0-4 today as a road favorite in the wrong position? Go ahead, John Ryan.
Yeah, I think you're on to something there. I think there's a lot of other better games to bet on, quite frankly. At this point, you can't trust the Bengals, and the Panthers are – they looked good last week, but can you trust them to do that kind of performance again? If you could, then they probably should be priced at pick 'em instead of a dog. 0-3 team on the road as a favorite is a red flag right away. So I like your idea with the home favorite or the home dog. I might add in the circa million contest, the differential between people picking the Bengals and the Panthers supports the Panthers, because 1,522 entries picked the Bengals, 467 on the Panthers. When it's ever more than 1,000 differential, it leans you towards that team that nobody likes. And what have we seen the last 3 weeks? We've seen major upsets. So if you're going to bet this game, it is the Panthers.
There you go. Talking about that dog, I like the Carolina Panthers as well. I say take a money line, win by one, lose by none here. The Bengals are reeling. Going over to you, Ronnie B., do you think that Joe Burrow, now that he's got Ja'Marr Chase back in the crew, get back into form? But it seems like the chip is falling up very fast in Cincinnati. Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to disagree with both of you, unfortunately. I like Mr. Burrow today. Let's look at this game. Let's look at this game preseason, okay? Cincinnati was a heavy favorite. It's come down to 4.5 today, but Burrow has got 5 touchdowns, no interceptions already to start the year. He's not getting any support from the defense right now. But the defense is going to go up against Carolina today. Yeah, we'll give Andy Dalton kudos last week, but who did he beat? He beat the Vegas Raiders. So I'm not impressed with his performance yet. Let's see what happens today. And I think what's going to happen today a little bit, Dalton is going to come out all juiced up because he's going against his old team that cut him. So I'm going to lean with, and I'm going to play Burrow myself, because I think Broadway Joe's not going to go 0-4.
Well, you just told me something here that was on my list. I was going to save to mention it, but the revenge factor here. Andy Dalton is going to be a dog all over the Cincinnati Bengals today. It's going to be a cat fight down there, guys. I'm telling you, when you look at this game, this is one of my picks of the day. You got to be smart. You got to look at where the money is going. And like you said, all the money's going on the Panthers, but you got two factors here. And Andy Dalton has got his sea legs back, got a win on the road. Now he's back at home in the dog position. Weird money at 4.5. I don't think the book is going to let you adjust it either way. Don't even know if this is on a teaser ticket. Cincinnati is reeling. Go with that home dog. Win by one, lose by none. If you want to take him into points, if you're scared as well. Let's move into another game that we had on our list. Rotation number 269, the Minnesota Vikings. What do you know? Talking about resurgent comebacks of quarterbacks, Sam Darnold, resurgent career, another top guy that came out a couple of seasons back out of USC. Plus 3 today in the dog position. I like him. Green Bay Packers got some good news. They got back Jordan Love. He may get the start today or may get some reps if things are not working out for Malik Willis. But minus 3 at home, minus 140 over and under in this one, which is the total, is 44. It was hard to cap it on the total, but I looked at the pricing for money line and spread, and again, I'm going with the dog here. Sam Darnold, in my opinion, has got the Minnesota Vikings clicking. They believe in him. He's got the number one weapon in Justin Jefferson, like I told you. Early touchdowns are going to be the key. I think Minnesota, if they're able to get out and get an early touchdown, at least a first quarter touchdown, even bigger blessing, a first quarter touchdown and a field goal to get 10 points inside of that plus 3, I think that gives you 3 shots to keep it close. John Ryan, your thoughts?
Well, I think the play is Minnesota. There's uncertainty with Jordan Love. I think he's activated. I haven't checked that injury report.
the civil authorities have issued a required monthly test for Churchill NV, Clark NV, Douglas NV, Elko NV, Esmeralda NV, Eureka NV, Humboldt NV, Lander NV, Lincoln NV, Lion NV, Mineral NV, Nye NV, Pershing NV, Story NV, Washoe NV, White Pine NV, and Carson City City NV, beginning at 8:31 a.m. and ending at 9:31 a.m. This is the Nevada State Police with a required monthly test of the emergency alert system. Federal, state, and local officials use CAAS to keep you informed in the event of an emergency or disaster through your local radio and TV stations and cable providers. This test helps ensure that EAS participants are ready to provide information in a crisis. This concludes today's test of the emergency alert system.
Go to Vikings in that dog position. Again, you guys can watch these games live, Fubo TV. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. That's going to save you guys a ton of money putting cash in your pocket 15 days or 15% off free. You can get 15 days free if you email me or go to the website and say, JB, I need another week. Check is a little short. I can reach out to the folks at Fubo to keep those games on. Also, we're streaming the NFL live with our partners over at Paramount Plus. You got to get to jbtheticket.com. I got all the stuff that you need to keep your streaming life cheap and flowing and not missing any games. You don't want to pick up all 5-10 apps. Don't know which one to watch. We are having technical difficulties connecting. That's because everybody's tuning into the game, but you won't have that happen with Fubo or Paramount Plus from VegasScoreboardExpress.com. Jaguars, another 0-3 team. Trevor Lawrence. Is it almost time for him to start looking maybe to pack some bags here? Because 0-3 going up against the Texans again. I got C.J. Stroud on my fantasy team as my starting quarterback. 2-1 are the Texans. Now, not time to panic, but we haven't seen too much dynamism out of C.J. Stroud. But on the other side of the football, we haven't seen anything out of Trevor Lawrence. He's got these guys 0-3. I thought Doug Peterson was the quarterback whisperer. John Ryan, I'm going to throw this one at you. Are the Texans to play today? Kind of expensive on the spread at -5.5. The Jaguars in a desperation position. A dog with fleas on the road. I don't believe in the Jaguars, and I think that these guys are going to get handled today. Go ahead.
Well, I'm disagreeing. I think this is going to be one of those games where there's just too many bets on the Texans right now. I mean, they are a loaded team, but why is this line 5? Anytime I think a pro bettor sees 5 in the NFL or 5.5, it draws your attention because it's really a number that's become more prevalent in the modern game of the NFL. But I think Jacksonville will get their act together. Peterson is a good coach. Let's not forget the guy won a Super Bowl for the Eagles back in 2018. So, and Trevor Lawrence is a Heisman Trophy winner. And a lot of times, yes, Heisman Trophy winners don't make it in the NFL, and maybe he is one of them. But he's too talented. And I think with their backs against the wall, they're going to come out smoking today, and I like the point.
Well, you talk about a team here full of injuries. You got Jacksonville. Tons of guys on the defensive side are out. On the offensive side for the Texans, tons of guys are out. So when you talk about that +5 going over to you, Ronnie B., do you like the dog here today? Because, again, with a lot of injuries in key positions on both sides of the football, do you think that the Texans, even though they're loaded, can get better? You've got guys that are out. You know, you got Collins out, wide receiver, hamstring. Got Joe Mixon, the running back, talking about Texans here, who came over from Cincinnati. He's questionable with an ankle. And then you also got Damian Pierce out with a hamstring. So from that dog position coming in on the road, if you're looking at it from the Jacksonville standpoint, they've got some defensive issues here with Jones out on the cornerback position. You got Bigsby, who was one of their, you know, third down running backs. He's out with a shoulder injury. I mean, this is going to be a tough game to cap. And John mentions it, that +5.5, 5.5 wager here. What do you think about that total looking at this game, maybe 44, 44.5? Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a game I passed on, but if I'm looking at it from a capping point, the line opened at 4, moved up to 6, now it's at 5.5. So the public is all over the Texans here. I think it's the glamour from last year and Stroud, how he performed. But if I'm going to bet that, I'm going to fade the public on this. I think Trevor might have a good game. I think they'll keep it within the number or maybe pull that upset up outright because they're not a bad team. They're just getting some bad breaks and some bad injuries, and it's just not put together yet. But I can't play the game, but if you're going to, I'd fade Texans and bet Jacksonville.
There you go. If the guys can't make a consensus, I can't either. Stay off of this game. One of the worst price games on the book list today. And that's why we have these conversations, to educate you bettors out there and sports fans who hear about your friends that are betting, even if you don't, so you can have some knowledge. Anytime you start seeing dead money in football betting, which is between 4.5 and 5.5 as a spread, try to look at the total. And even with that total today having the hook, this is just a tough game to bet. Stay off of it. Two dogs with fleas, two turds in the bucket. See which one goes down first is how we are looking at that game. Guys, we're going to take a short commercial break. John Ryan, are you still going to be able to be with us? Go ahead.
I'm going to have to take off, JD and Ryan. I love being on the show, and I'm sure he'll finish down the stretch here just fine without me.
There you go. John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook. What's your best play today before you get out of here, my friend? Go ahead.
The best place to find me is on the X at John Ryan Sports in the number one, and then also the predictiveplaybook.com. And I write articles for a lot of different places, like rotowire.com. Check me out on the X, though, to get all the information you need to get the plays for the day, and I'll give them to you for free.
There you go. John Ryan is going to hook you guys up with the free plays today. Not giving one out on the show. You got to get over to that website. You guys support him. John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook. Thank you so much for stopping by. Ronnie B., any quick shout-outs before we take this commercial break? Go ahead.
Yeah, we're going to say good morning to Roger up there. He finally tuned in and listened to us. He said he's listening to the show.
Thank you so much, Roger, for tuning in. And tell all your friends to tune in as well. JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express, because we're doing one thing, getting money.
You're listening to the boss of the big board.
Steiner's, the Nevada Style Pub, invites you to play the best tavern, keno, and video poker in Vegas. Promos are how we roll, so make the most of your gaming dollars here with us. Come play our proud partner gaming promotion, Fly Aviators Fly, and receive daily free play, bonuses, and more. With a chance to win awesome brand of prizes and big money for all the jackpots each week. It's not only great gaming that Steiner's Pub has, it's the 24 awesome rotating draft beers, Vegas' best appetizers to match. So join us in supporting your Las Vegas Aviators, Golden Knights, Lights, Aces, and the Raiders, as we make history in Vegas. Steiner's, the Nevada Style Pub at 8410 West Cheyenne, 1750 North Buffalo, and Las Vegas Boulevard at Windmill. Steiner's, I love this place.
Skip your cable bill this month and join the action with JB and Fubo TV. Get 7 days free, 15% off your first month. No credit check, no deposit, no installation hassle. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. Sign up, download the app, and start watching games.
Enjoy being a subscriber after the first month. Easy cancellation anytime. Regional restrictions apply. Sign up at VegasScoreboardExpress.com.
At the Bagel Cafe, the recipe is simple. Good food and generous portions. Family owned and operated since 1996, the Bagel Cafe is a unique restaurant where you can get anything your appetite desires. From a bagel and a schmear to piled high corned beef on homemade rye, fresh fruit platters and salads, or creamy New York cheesecake. Check them out at thebagelcafelv.com. The Bagel Cafe, where there's something delicious for everyone.
Vegas Scoreboard Express, JB the Ticket, back at you live here in Las Vegas. Again, shout out my guys over at Predictive Sports Betting Playbook, John Ryan. He's one of the best guys, John Ryan. Had to fix that microphone there. John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook, rotowire.com. Still got him on the line with me, my main man, Ronnie B. here from the Rampart Casino. One of the best. Gave out Alabama yesterday. Good play, good win. Also want to give a shout-out to my main man, Rodney Newpool, Noob Sports, or his brother, Ryan, always supporting the show. Appreciate you guys. So, Ronnie, let's get back into it. NFL is on deck here. If you want to get Ronnie B's plays, Ronnie, they find you over on Instagram. Where at?
Ronnie B, 702, R-O-N-N-Y-B, 702.
There you go. Let's make it happen. Now, let's talk about another interesting game between two young, dynamic quarterbacks. Rotation number 279. You got Jaden Daniels getting the start today on the road out in Arizona. Going up against rotation number 280, the Arizona Cardinals under Kyler Murray. They seem to be playing a little bit better. Kyler has got these guys believing. They're 1-2 right now, but they are playing tough football. The Commanders at 2-1 today, -3.5 for the Cardinals, okay? They're giving the Commanders the dog position. Now, when you look at Jaden Daniels, he's got this guy named Terry McLaurin, who's on my fantasy list today. I think he's going to have a good game. But Kyler Murray, I'd counted him out a couple of seasons ago, the injuries, but he's come back in a resurgent form, okay? 59 of 86, 635 yards, five touchdowns, only one interception. And he's got 64 fantasy points already. Very, very efficient quarterback this year. And again, Jaden Daniels, the dynamic rookie, doing very, very well. 61 of 76 for 664 yards. He's only thrown two touchdowns, relying a lot on the run in Washington, but he's got no interception. So again, Ronnie B., thank you for being here and staying on the line with us. Talking about this Washington team, relying on a rookie quarterback, going up against a quasi-veteran in Arizona. How do you see this one matching up?
Well, I'll tell you what, last week I watched that Commanders game and going up against Burrow. So Jaden had some incentive because they both come from LSU, and he was making comments that, oh, Joe did this, Joe did that. So I think he proved last week that he was up to the task, which he did. I watched the game. He had a great game. Today, I think it's a different story. I think he's going up against an Arizona defense that's a lot better than what Cincinnati threw at him. The number, as we were talking earlier, started at 5.5 points. It's down to 3.5. Opened up 5.5, down to 3.5. So the money's coming in on Washington. Everybody's excited about Jaden Daniels because they saw what he did. I'm leaning towards Arizona. I love Kyler Murray here at home.
Yes, I'm leaning towards him as well. Very rarely do I pick the favorites. I wish I could buy him down to a -1, though. Do I think the Commanders can play? Yes, but you talked about that defense. Cardinals should be a dog that's barking here. They've got less wins, but there's a reason they are favored at home. Now, with that +3.5, the money coming down, let's take a look at that total of over 49. Do you think Kyler can get us 28 points, give us four touchdowns, a couple of field goals, and then whatever the Commanders can get in there pushes us over the top? 49, over or under, Ronnie B.?
I'll tell you what, this is a client play, and I'm going to give it out here on the radio for you. I took the over 49. I think they're both going to still light it up, but I think the Cardinals will come out on top. But I think the points are going to be put up on the board, lighting it up.
There you go. You got two young quarterbacks wanting to approve themselves. Let's move along again to the hometown Las Vegas Raiders, dog position, playing the Cleveland Browns. Now, the Cleveland Browns got their own quarterback issues. Deshaun Watson hasn't necessarily stepped up, if you will. He might need to call back Diddy for some of those baby blow bottles that he's gone missing. But anyway, the point that I'm making is, can the Raiders get it back to form, okay? They're 1-2. The Browns are 1-2. This used to be a classic game between Cleveland and Oakland, and now they're the Vegas Raiders. Live here at Allegiant Stadium, you guys definitely need to get over to KSHP.com, pick up a couple of those ticket packages. But the line started off at 2.5, and now I've seen on some boards it's down to +1. Are the Raiders going to be able to get over the hump today? They're sitting Devontae Adams. Max Crosby's going to be on the bench. They've made their business decisions. And with that being said, do you think that's going to be good business or bad business for the Raiders? Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you, this is, once again, it's like I said last week, I can't really look at the Raiders too much right now. I don't like them from top to bottom, from ownership to management to what's going on with the Raiders right now. And they got beat last week by Carolina. So they're not really, I don't know what they're doing. I think they're in quicksand right now. I can't touch this game. I don't like anything about it. The number flipped from -1 to -2.5. Cleveland's getting the money. Raiders are sitting out players. I just can't touch this game.
Telling you to stay off of it. The bombs are falling. Let's move along to another game here that we've got on our list. We talked about it a couple of weeks ago. A lot of folks have been wondering about this team because the Saints started out hot. They took that loss last week on the Monday night game. Short week types of teams. The Saints have got two back-to-back weeks in this situation today. They're on the road against the Falcons, who were able to come out with an impressive dog win last week. But the Saints, former Raiders quarterback Derek Carr, is another one of these quarterbacks with a career resurgence on another team. Taking a look at his stats, 44 of 64, 585 yards, six touchdowns, two picks. A little bit more pedestrian down in Atlanta, though. You got Kirk Cousins. He got let go out of Minnesota, came down south to Atlanta, 56 of 84, 626 yards, four touchdowns, but three picks. This guy's a pick monster. Still a pick monster. So when you look at the Saints today, Ronnie B., I'm liking the Saints today on the road. If they can get in the dog position and stay in the dog position, that would be a good play for you. But I've been seeing a lot of money come in on the Saints today. +2.5, 3.5, New Orleans, +3, +125 on the money line. Rotation number 263, New Orleans Saints going down to Atlanta. Rotation number 264. Now, we did see some good work out of Kirk Cousins last week. We saw good work out of the Atlanta defense. But do the Saints bounce back? Alvin Kamara, best running back so far statistically this season. Do you think that they can shred that defense? Because Atlanta did not have a great run defense last week, but they were able to get the win. Saints are much better. Go ahead, Ronnie B.
Okay, I've been looking at this game because I'm going to put some my own money on this one, JB. I'm leaning towards Atlanta, and let me tell you why that is. Atlanta has faced three foes. Their record is 8-1. They beat Philly last week. Atlanta beat Philly.
Yeah, they did.
Philly beat the Saints last week. Philly outgained the Saints 460 yards to 219. Okay, I just think I think Kamara is questionable from what I heard, so that's an if for the money out there. But I got to go with Atlanta here at home, and I think you got two old timers, Carr and Cousins. They're going to battle it out, but I'm going to give the lean towards Atlanta based on what they've been playing better foes. And let's see what happens.
There you go. He likes Atlanta, New Orleans in a tight spread. I think this is their comeback week, a la the Eagles last week. They're in a double short week situation, and I don't think that the brass down there wants to see Derek Carr getting one of those lulls like he did out here in Las Vegas. So, Ronnie, we're going to round it out when we come back from the short commercial break. It's time to get over to the book, people. Cutting it short today. All money, all sports, no bull. Get to my website, jbtheticket.com. Sign up for Fubo TV. Sign up for Paramount Plus. We got Fanatics on there, all your jerseys, game apparel. I've even got game tickets on there if you guys want to get over to Allegiant Stadium, start supporting UNLV. Looking at these Raiders today in a dog position. Again, that's a game I'm staying off of. So when we get back from the short commercial break, best plays of the day. Ronnie B., any more shout-outs to some of your great listeners out there? I know you've been promoting the show. I really appreciate it. We've been on the air here since 2017. This December will be 7 years that JB the Ticket is bringing you grease. I want to give a shout-out to the guy that got me in this business, my main man Vern Vivio out here in Las Vegas. That was Raging Vic Vivio's brother back in the day. But I'm telling you, it's been a great football season so far. Ronnie B., go ahead and take us to break.
I'll tell you what, I just want to give a shout-out to a few of the guys there at the Rampart. Mike, I told him to play Bama, don't be afraid, let it go.
There you go.
He did, he was happy.
Ronnie B. making him happy over at the Rampart. We're making you happy here live, 107.1 FM and AM 1400. Stick with us, best plays of the day. When we get back, we're getting to the book, getting some money.
You're listening to the boss of the big four, JP the Ticket. Vegas scoreboard express, giving you that grease. Skip your cable bill this month and join the action with JP and Fubo TV. Get 7 days free, 15% off your first month. No credit check, no deposit, no installation hassle. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. Sign up, download the app, and start watching games.
Enjoy being a subscriber after the first month. Easy cancellation anytime. Regional restrictions apply. Sign up at VegasScoreboardExpress.com.
As a three-time international award-winning restaurant, Joe's New York Pizza uses only the freshest and best available ingredients. From giant slices of hand-tossed pie to calzone, strombolis, fingers, and wings, Joe's serves all your favorites. Stop in for a slice at one of their two Las Vegas locations at Paradise and Harmon or South Las Vegas Boulevard, or you can check out their menu at joesnewyorkpizzalv.com.
Back at you live, JB the Ticket, Vegas Scoreboard Express. Thank you guys so much for tuning in this morning. Ronnie B., you're still on the line with me over at the Rampart. I know you're getting ready to load up for a very, very expensive day with your clients. Go ahead.
I'm still here, my friend.
All right. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Best plays of the day again. Thank you guys. John Ryan, Predictive Sports Betting Playbook, Rodney Newple. Again, shout out to my main man, Daryl Harris, KLAS, CBS 8 here in Las Vegas for his contributions. Looks like Caitlin Clark won that Rookie of the Year. I know you had a ticket on it. That's why I'm giving you a shout out. Good work, my man. So, Ronnie, what's your best play of the day? I'll give my best play of the day, and then we'll get out of here. Go ahead.
I'm going to take it to the last game of the day, the Baltimore-Buffalo game. I'm going to go with the Ravens, -2.
He likes the Ravens minus two. Should be in a dog position. I'm sticking with my Minnesota Vikings today, folks. I like him in that dog position, plus 2.5. If Sam Darnold and Justin Jefferson can get some real grease going, even though Lambeau's a tough place to play, I think they can pull it out. And again, we got some Monday Night Football plays for the website tomorrow, jbtheticket.com. Follow Ronnie B, RonnieB702. Follow John Ryan, John Ryan Predictive Sports Betting Playbook, at John Ryan Sports 1 on the Expert, and me on Instagram at JBTheTicket and my website, JBTheTicket.com. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today. Ronnie B, we're getting ready to say it together, brother. We're getting out of here. You know what time it is. It's time to get the money.
You're listening to the boss of the big boy, JB the Ticket. Vegas scoreboard is bright. Giving you that green. Skip your cable bill this month and join the action with JB and Fubo TV. Get 7 days free, 15% off your first month. No credit check, no deposit, no installation hassle. Go to FuboTV.com/JB. Sign up, download the app, and start watching games.
Enjoy being a subscriber after the first month. Easy cancellation anytime. Regional restrictions apply. Sign up at VegasScoreboardExpress.com.